diamond and rocks all the time. Now I call our coordinator Sada sir to please come and introduce the experience how they have had with 10th class.
Just a few minutes.
We have a very good lecture on a very important topic, and you may consider I am just killing time. Somewhere I read, team. What is a team? The feeling of enjoying each other's success makes a team. And unless team members learn to enjoy each other's success, the team won't work. No one will be able to coordinate if the team members don't allow him to. So in a way, whenever you will succeed, I'm sure you will, the credit will go to the team only. And I am just a part of him. Just one
man, human.
Just a few days back, I read a very good, not an article, a kind of narration. Somewhere in Italy, a man, a person, he went to a hotel to enjoy a cup of coffee. He went there, sat in a chair. The waiter came, he ordered a cup of coffee, and he was waiting for the cup of coffee. Suddenly he saw one more person entering the hotel. He was just watching what that person would say. And the person ordered the waiter to bring two coffees. Bring me two coffees, one for me and one for the wall. I was curious to read further. One for me, one for the wall. The waiter brought the coffee the person asked for. But the person took his time to take it because he was curious to know what was that one coffee for the wall. The waiter came, gave him a cup of coffee, and he had a piece of paper, he stuck it on the wall, one coffee. The person paid for two coffees and went away. Once again, two more people came and they asked the waiter to bring them three coffees, two for them, one for the wall. The waiter delivered them their order, two coffees, one more piece of paper on the wall, one coffee. So he was wondering what was happening. Please sir, please come. So he could not understand what was happening. So once, twice, thrice it happened. But he took his coffee and went away. After a few days, that person, same fellow, came back to the hotel. Once again he sat in a chair. Once again he asked for a cup of coffee. And then he saw that a very poor looking, just a beggar like person, came to the hotel. Sat in a chair. The waiter came to him, bowed down before him, asked what he could do for that fellow. The beggar said, one coffee from the wall please. The waiter went to the kitchen, brought a cup of coffee, served with due respect. The person took the cup of coffee, and as the person left paying no bill, the waiter took one of the sheets from the wall. Took one of the sheets from the wall broke it into two, tear it into pieces and threw it. Now this fellow understood what was happening. Every customer who used to be there, they were in a way asking coffees for them and donating for those who don't afford. Now this is the best way to do something for someone who really needs it. Now just imagine a beggar in a hotel, the waiter was giving full respect. The beggar was not begging for a cup of tea or coffee. He had the courage to come, to see, to ask for a coffee. Dear friends, this is what education should do. When I was in a school, I always used to ask my headmaster, "Sir, if you really want to do something for so-called poor students, don't make them to come on stage to receive whatever you give them. It's not fair to, what would they feel?" Now, I am taking a cup of coffee and I am paying one more coffee for someone else whom I don't know. Don't you think this is the way to help someone if you really want to? And this is what I think really what we should call being human. Help someone. Did that beggar know who was the fellow who paid for his coffee? If that particular thing had not been done in that hotel, do you think the owner of the hotel would have allowed that beggar to come in the hotel? Do you think the